Hi there. If you still struggle to work with recording settings dialogue in Active Presenter 8, this video is perfectly right for you. As you may already know, there are two recording options available, which are recording video and recording software simulation. Respectively, there are recording settings for video dialogue and recording settings for software simulation dialogue. They are quite similar, yet slightly different. We will cover both in this video. To open the settings dialog, click the settings icon on the top right of the Record Software Simulation Project dialog, or the Record Video Project dialog in case of video recording. Select Recording Settings. As the settings dialog appears, you can notice that it has four different tabs, which are Audio and Video, Cursor, Annotation, and Hotkeys. Let's go through each of them. In the Audio and Video tab, there are three sections. The first one is Video Settings, which includes Video Codec lets you choose between two types. Flash Screen Video allows you to create videos with quality reserved. With the other one, H.264, videos created will have a smaller file size but not fully reserved quality. The second type of video codec is recommended when you record video demos, especially streaming videos, when high frame rate is more necessary than high video quality. The frame rate here should be between 20 and 30 frames per second. A too high value may increase your video size and overload some low configuration computers. On the other hand, too low values make your video appear jerky. The quality spin box will only be available if you choose the second type of video codec, which is H.264. Select the value from 1 to 100. The higher the value, the higher the video quality, thus, the larger video file size. Tick this to reduce the chance of overloading while recording the screen with a very high frame rate. Next is the audio settings section. There are three audio codec types for you to choose from. 16-bit PCM let you create audio with a reserved quality. Vorbis and MP3 allow you to lower the file size, however quality will not be reserved. Sample rate decides the fidelity of the audio. Higher fidelity means better audio quality, and also higher file size. The recommendation value for this is 48,000 Hz. There are two options for channels here. With mono, the audio will be recorded as single channel. On the other hand, with stereo, two audio channels will be recorded instead of one. As a result, the file size will be doubled. When no special audio quality is needed, the mono channel is good enough for recording video demonstrations or software simulations. Similar to video settings, this quality spin box will only be available for Vorbis codec type. Select between 1 to 100 as the level of audio quality desired. The quality spin box will be replaced with the bitrate select box in case you chose MP3 codec. There are four options available here: 64, 96, 128 and 256 kilobits per second. This number indicates the amount of bits that are conveyed per second. The higher the bit rate, the better the audio quality. If file storage is not a matter, choose 256 kilobits per second, which provides much better audio quality than 128 kilobits per second and the rest. This advanced screenshot capture section is built exclusively for Record Software Simulation. Before you click a button for a period of time, Active Presenter will take a screenshot. The number in this spin box indicates the amount of time in milliseconds. The default value is 500 milliseconds. Change them to fit your preference. For record video, this section will be replaced with webcam settings, which lets you choose the video codec for webcam recording. Same as in video settings, there are flash screen video and H.264. The next one is the cursor tab, which contains four sections. The cursor settings section contains three tick boxes. Ticking this box allows Active Presenter to record the movement of mouse cursor on screen. Tick the second box if you want to edit the cursor properties like cursor highlight, click sounds and effects later on. Tick the third box to get rid of the unwanted layered windows that may appear on screen while recording. The cursor path section here is only available for Record Software Simulation. It gives you three options for cursor path recording, with real movement, mouse movements on the screen will be recorded truthfully in real time. With the other two, mouse movements on the screen will be recorded and saved as either straight or curved lines. All the unnecessary movement will be cleared out. This might make the simulation look more simplified and professional. Cursor effects like cursor highlight, click effects and sounds can be included or excluded by selecting on or off in this section. Additionally, there's a third option, which is theme settings. This option lets you record with a custom cursor effect that was set up previously. Check out this video for detailed instruction. If you want to freely move the blue rectangle to any part of the screen while recording, you might be interested in auto panning. Tick this box to enable the feature. Adjust the panning speed here, as it is the speed that the blue rectangle follows your mouse cursor. Keep in mind that this feature is only applicable when the blue rectangle is smaller than the recorded application screen. This annotation tab is exclusively built for record software simulation. It gives you controls over annotations and interactions for the mouse and keyboard, which will be generated after recording. Check this box if you want to add annotations for mouse click event. And this box for keystroke, text entry. Annotations here will be in the form of shapes with text inside that tell learners how to behave in a specific step. Check this box for auto-generated feedback messages after the mouse click. By default, only incorrect feedback messages are created. Tick this box to add the correct messages. And this box for hover messages. It is similar for keystroke and text entry. Tick this box to enable feedback messages. Tick here for correct messages. And here for hover messages. This is an essential feature for software simulation. It lets users see the outcome of their actions, so they immediately know if they are right or not. Tick this box to keep all the annotations that are automatically added inside the active window area. This option is quite important when you choose to view or export the active window area only. The last tab is Hotkeys tab. It allows you to set the shortcuts for some of the most usually used functions while recording. Select the Use Hotkeys checkbox to activate all the properties. Then click any command box and press a key, or a combination of keys to assign new hotkeys. You can always go back to the default setup by clicking the Restore Defaults button. Finally, click Save to save all the customization you have in each tab and close the dialog. That's everything you need to know about recording settings dialog. Hope you find this video helpful. Thank you for watching.